Now we have the question on the board. The question says a cylinder with air has a radius of 2 meters. The density of air is 1.29 kg per meter cube. We have to find the width if we have the height of the cylinder to be 5 meters and we have to find the specific gravity of air. Now there are some formulas we'll be using today. Now to solve the first part of our question, for the A part, we have to find the width. And our formula for width is equals to mass times gravity. But if you check our question, we have to use those values we are given. We all know gravity to be 9.81. But since we don't have the value for mass here, we are going to be substituting this mass with density times volume, and then we have our times gravity, because our mass is equal to density times volume. Now we are given the density of this of air, and now we have to find the volume of air in the cylinder. We all know that the volume of the cylinder is equal to pi r squared h. Now our pi is 3.142, and our radius from our question is 2 meters times 2 meters squared. Then we have our height to be 5 meters. The final answer for our volume here is 62.84 meters cubed. Now we have our answer for our volume. We have our answer for density is 1.29. So we do direct substitution into the formula for width. Our width now is equals to 1.29, which is our density, 1.29 kilogram per meter cube, times our volume is 62.84 meter cube. And we have our gravity to be 9.81 meters per second squared. Now, multiplying this all to find our width, our answer is 794.23. Now, the SI unit for width here, we all know all those SI units we have are very, they are very, very, very important in solving a physics question. Now, our SI unit for width is newton. The specific gravity. If I to find the specific gravity of air, specific gravity compares the density of a substance with the density of water. Now, if I to compare this, if I to find the specific gravity, we are comparing that density of air to that of water. Now, specific gravity is equals to the density, this is rho, the density of air compared to the density of water. And we are given our density of air to be 1.29. kilogram per meter cube. And our density of water is a constant value, which is 1 kilogram per meter cube. Now we do direct substitution for this into this formula. We would have 1.29 kilogram per meter cube all over 1 kilogram per meter cube. This cancels this. Therefore, the specific gravity of air is equals to 1.29. Since these units have cancelled each other, we don't have a unit for that. That is like when we are comparing the differences between specific gravity and gravity. Like from our question, we used a unit for gravity per meters per second squared, which makes gravity gravity to have dimension. But specific gravity is dimensionless, because if you can see from this formula we used here, the units of both densities have cancelled out each other. Now this is basically solving for the specific gravity and the width. When we are dealing with hydrostatics, we also deal with pressure and the rest of them. And we'll be talking about pressure, buoyancy. Archimedes principle in our next class. Stay tuned. Thank you for watching.